So, Devon, welcome back.
Thank you.
We're talking about assessments now, not tests or exams, but mm-hmm. we're talking about how to try and assess the case of auditory processing disorder. What sort of methods do we use?
Well, basically, there are two ways we can assess auditory processing disorder. First and foremost, we must ensure that we have checked the student's hearing acuity. So we don't do anything until we make sure that it isn't a hearing problem.
Right.
Then the audiologist does what we call a bottom-up assessment. Once they've checked that the student's hearing is fine, the hearing acuity, they do a series of very specific assessments that look at the auditory processing functions from the ear to the brain, all those different aspects that have been identified once the sound leaves the ear and travels to the auditory cortex in the brain. So they'll be doing things like getting the student to listen to signals that are going into one ear while they have to ignore a sound in the other ear.
Right, that could be, well, that sounds hard.
It's quite difficult.
That sounds difficult.
So they're looking at how the two ears can separate what's being heard, or in other assessments, how the two ears can integrate what's being heard. So one part of a message will be put in one ear and the other half in the other ear. Mm. Can the two parts of the brain bring that message together and integrate that information?
Wow.
There's a whole series of assessments that the audiologist does, and from those assessments they can look at the different aspects of processing that the child might be having a difficulty with.
Okay.
Then the speech pathologist will do what we call a top-down assessment. So we're really looking at the functional aspects of auditory processing. How well is the student able to understand what's being heard, their receptive language? Mm. How well do they follow instructions and remember instructions? How well they can discriminate between sounds? Can they hear the difference between very similar words?
Mm.
We'll also look at all of their literacy skills, their reading, spelling, written language, because we know that aspects of auditory processing have a huge impact on those skills. So particularly if you're having difficulty with that processing of speech sounds, you know, you have a lot of difficulty, for example, spelling, you'll leave out a letter in a word or you'll write the wrong letter.
So it's basically there's two sides to it. There's the audiology,
right,
and then there's the speech pathology.
That's right.
So that's there's
right.
two disciplines working
that's
in
right.
harmony together
that's
there.
Right.
Does it take long to get a result?
Usually the visit to the audiologist is about an hour to an hour and a half, and for the speech pathologist we'd be looking around about 2 hours. So we wouldn't do those at the same occasion, we'd probably do those on two separate occasions.
Right. So there's a lot of work happening, but it's a reasonably quick result.
Yes, usually, particularly with the audiologist, they're able to give the parent feedback, verbal feedback on the spot.
Wow.
And then
okay.
usually provide the parent with a written report following that. And similar in speech pathology, we can usually give some feedback straight away because it's fairly obvious when we have a student with an auditory processing disorder. And then we will score our assessments and give them a more detailed report with actual measures of skills.
Yeah, I was going to ask a little bit related to that. Is it a case where if there is a significant case or a serious case, does the assessment become more complicated?
Not really. I mean, it's just more of, and if it's a very complicated case, that will be more obvious because there'll be a lot more skills that are in deficit and there are a lot more aspects of auditory processing that they're having trouble with.
And do the people normally respond quite well to being assessed?
Usually, it depends on the age of the child and how well they've been prepared for the assessment.
Yes.
Unfortunately, some of the children we see have been dragged around from pillar to post in the parents' attempts to, they know something's not right with their child, and they'll often go from here to there seeking an answer. So sometimes when the child gets to us, they've been to a lot of things and they say, oh no, not another one. But we put them at ease and we usually, you know, we make it a very fun, entertaining, you know, process really. So most of the children really enjoy the process.
Oh, that's good. So it's so it can be a very positive experience.
Yes, I had a young man just 2 weeks ago, he came to me, he's 16, and he struggled with school. He'd never ever had any kind of assessment. And he admitted to his father a couple of weeks ago that he actually couldn't understand anything he read and was really struggling in the classroom.
Well, that's a big admission for a 16-year-old.
Yes, and the dad brought him to me and I did my assessment, and it was very, very obvious to me in a very short frame of time that this young man had a huge deficit with auditory processing.
Wow, yeah.
When I explained to him that he actually had a problem with a name, he walked out the happiest boy on earth, because he said to me, "I just thought I was stupid."
Wow.
But once it was explained to him that he was actually a very smart, intelligent young man, but he had this very specific problem, which was really impacting on his ability to follow the teacher's instruction, listen to classroom conversation. It was also impacting his reading and comprehension of what he read. He was so relieved. He was just enormously relieved to know that he actually had a problem with a name, and more importantly, that we can do something about it.
Well, that's very positive. Devon, thank you.
My pleasure.